It's something that, oh, if you know that you have your money, you can get it, but you don't need to come and start saying you want to collect something on credit when you don't have the money. It's something that even though you have that money, you get more than that, you get something higher than that price. You have your money, nobody will tell you that, madam, don't buy that thing. You're in charge. No one will come and tell you that, oh, you're not going to buy that thing. It's your money. You're the one that got your money yourself. You understand? Welcome back to my YouTube channel. It's your favorite girl, Rachel Favy. So in today's video, I'm talking about five smart money habits you should practice in your 20s. Do you know what came about this topic? Like, seriously, I've been thinking about a lot of things of late. Like, I've been thinking of how to make money, what am I going to do when I'm done in school, a lot of things. Yeah, and I'm in my 20s. Yeah, so I'm just thinking about a lot of things. So I don't know, maybe it's because I'm actually in my finals in school, because by December I'll be done by the grace of God. So I don't really know, maybe that's what is prompting me to do that. I guess that's what's prompting me to do that. That's what's prompting me to do that. Because when you're done in school, you need to start thinking of, you need to know something. You're no longer a burden to your parents. They are expecting from you. They have trained you. They are expecting from you. They are expecting you to, start giving them, start taking care of them, all those things. So I've been thinking of it like, oh God, like this, let me start practicing some habits now. You understand what I'm trying to say? So I've been able to list out five things. So let me share it with the people. I say, let me come and share it with you. You know, you're my family. You understand? So number one goes there's be creative. Yeah, you need to learn new skills, a lot of things you can learn out there, fashion designing, hairdressing, a lot of things you can learn out there. See, let me tell you something, there are a lot of graduates that they release every year, that are graduating every year. You understand what I'm trying to say? So the economy now, it's nothing to talk about. You understand what I'm saying? So you don't need to depend on what you study in school. See, everyone that studies accounting or anyone that studies engineering, there's like tendency that they may not even use that to work and get money. You understand what I'm trying to say? When they come out, you get. So let's say I studied a particular thing now. That does not mean I've come out and I'm working with it. You need to be creative. You need to learn more new skills. That's the major thing. If you can learn that, you can be able to survive, you can be able to feed yourself, even though without going outside to beg for money or something, you can be able to feed yourself. That's the major thing. Yeah, so number two goes towards, you need to invest. Yeah, see, invest in things that are legit though. Don't invest in things that next week like this, we just said I've shut down. Invest, let me tell you something, before you invest, verify it, make research, make findings, ask a lot of things. Don't just say you want to invest in a particular thing. If you invest and later on you are expected to get the money, you will not get it, because that's when you'll be getting anything. Let's say that they have shut that place down or something. I know of someone that they invested money in a particular thing, and I know a lot of people, not even one person, like they invested money in a particular thing, and at the end of the day, when they want to get the money back, that's when they're shut down or something. Maybe the person running away, they now start saying EFCC is pushing the person or so, looking for the person. And I know that no matter what, at the end of the day, you'll be able to get that money. That is it. So I want you to just try to invest. But if you're investing, make findings. So make findings. In short, there's no even to invest in all those kind of things. When I'm talking about invest, you need to try and invest in something that you know that, it's gonna generate more income to you. You know that something you're going to use, that even though it's for you to get some equipment. You understand, friends? It's something that you know that, you'll be getting a particular money at the end of the day. Okay, fine. There's some people that have money and they are able to get car, and they'll even give it to someone and say they should be working, and at the end of the month, the person must come back and give them money. You understand? Pay them. Or better still, some people do that weekly. You pay them money weekly. That's what I'm trying to say. Even though you cannot see the other way, but you can at least use your money to invest in other things. You understand what I'm trying to say? So just, we need to invest in something that is going to bring more fortune to us, that is going to bring more money to us. Yeah. So the next one goes as boring. Let me tell you, boring is not good. It actually drags you back because the money you will have now, you're supposed to use and focus on something. You just remember that, oh, you are only somebody. You understand what I'm trying to say? You are only somebody and you need to pay the person back. Some things go, so you might borrow money from someone and you need to pay interest. Imagine you pay that interest, what would you be left with? So, like, boring is not good though. Me, I would not advise you to start boring. Now, for instance, even I'm talking about boring now, for instance, now, you go to a store. See, like, people are marketers, they know how to market their business. They will tell you that, oh, see this wig, it costs 100,000 naira. Don't worry, just pay instrumentally and it's yours. Just pay instrumentally. See, them, you are a debtor to that person. It's something that, oh, if you know that you have your money, you can get it, but you don't need to come and start saying you want to collect something on credit when you don't have the money. It's something that even though you have that money, you get more than that, you get something higher than that price. Not waiting until that particular, like, you need to come and pay in a particular money instead of it using money to do something to generate yourself, to improve yourself, a lot of things, like, why would you borrow? Borrowing is not good. See, if I go out with a friend and they want to get something, like, I'll remove my face. I'll remove my face so it's not going to enter my eyes. Because I know that, oh, I don't have that money as at that time. When I have the money, I'll get it. But, okay, now let me tell you a scenario. For instance, now, there is a particular wig, like, I and my friend said that we want to get. So, when I heard the price, I looked at it and I said, I'm not working yet though. I said to myself, like, I'm not working yet. Why will I get this? Even though I have that money, I'll now put the money in something. Tell me to use it to generate myself, to develop myself, so I'll be able to buy more than that wig or something. Do you know, I had to call my friend and say, see, babe, kole work. I had to say, kole work. I cannot buy that wig now. You understand? Because I looked at the price. I'm finishing school. Where else do I be getting money from? I need to think about a lot of things, how to develop myself. I don't just need to sit back there. See, that's the mistakes a lot of people make. A lot of people make that mistake. Yeah, that is it. So, boring is not good. Long throat is not good. Long throat is more like borrowing or something. You don't need to borrow money to get a particular ashoebi or something. If fine, you're going for a wedding and you don't have that money to go for it, but don't just say you want to feel among or something. You don't need to kill yourself to get it. If at all you have money, then you can be able to buy a gift for the person. You understand what I'm trying to say? If you don't have the money, fine. But if you know you have the money, you can do it. But right now, I don't think one just need to lavish money like that, except if you know that, oh, you have excess, you understand, or you have a source of income, you know, something that you have invested in and you know that, oh, you are getting that money from that particular thing. Yeah, the next one goes thus: you are financially responsible for your life. See, there is nothing that is not as sweet as you being independent. There is nothing that is not as sweet as you being independent at all. See, if you're independent, you can get your money, you see something and you love that thing, you get it anytime you like. You understand? You don't need to come and start waiting, oh, I'm waiting for something. See, let me tell you something. You can't come and, you're in your early 20s now, you can't come and start saying that, oh, when you get married, you'll be able to focus, you'll be able to think, you'll be able to invest in something, be able to have your own shop, be able to develop yourself. Let me tell you something. But once you get married, kids will come in. That's when you will need to get some things for your kids. Now you'll be focusing more on your kids. You'll be able to have time. Because if you want to get an hustle or something, you still need to think of where my baby is going to stay, the food, all those things. Think about a lot of things. So it's something that you are financially responsible for yourself. If you have your money, nobody will tell you that, madam, don't buy that thing. You're in charge. No one will come and tell you that, oh, you're not going to buy that thing. It's your money. You're the one that got your money yourself. You understand what I'm trying to say? So it's something that, oh, you need, you are in charge of it. So you just need to also, you need to think about it on how to be independent. Don't be dependent on anyone. Even though you get married today, it's not good for you to be dependent on your husband. You understand what I'm trying to say? You need to be independent. You need to stand for yourself. There is no man, I'm very sure, let's say, there is no man that will like a lady that is dependent. You need to be independent. If at all it's for you to get something that, oh, it's bringing you small, small money, it's something. You understand? The last one goes thus, think of your future and focus on your goals. This is supposed to be number one. This is supposed to be number one. You know, I said that I've been thinking of late. I've been thinking of my future. Yeah, that is, it's supposed to be number one. Like, you need to think of your future and think of your goals and objective, what you want to achieve, what you want to attain in life. Yes, that is it. You need to think of, see, I said it's like, let's say, I said it's not quite long. I said, I've been thinking about my future. Very soon I'll be done in school by the grace of God. What else? You understand? Like, people be looking up to me. I don't just want to be that kind of person that will just go back home and be seated in a particular thing, not actually thinking. You understand what I'm trying to say? Not actually thinking about a particular thing. You understand? So, we need to think about our future. We need to think about our goals. See, everyone likes someone that is successful in life. Everyone likes it. If you say you graduated with a particular thing in school, people are not after that one. As far as they can see reward, sorry to say, as far as they can see it, they need to see it. You understand? I'm trying to say, oh, you went to school, okay, fine, you need to come and start taking care of us, you need to start dropping money, all those things. So that is it. So this brings me to the end of today's video. Don't forget to put down in the comment section below your own view about this and other smart money tips that I'm unable to list over here. So I'll see you in the next video. Bye.